There is a reason that the word of God commands us to walk after the spirit and not after the flesh, to not be carnally minded but spiritually minded. Galatians 5:16-17. This I say then, walk in the spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary the one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. Romans 8:4-6. That the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the spirit the things of the spirit. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. 1 John 2:15-17. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. There is no two ways about it. When you walk after the flesh, you will reap the things of the flesh. When you walk after the Spirit, you will reap the things of the Spirit. You reap what you sow. It's a spiritual principle. Galatians 6:7. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Because when you are walking and living in the flesh, you are easy prey for Satan and his demons. Very easy prey. But Satan cannot touch those who walk after the Spirit. He can and will try, but he cannot touch them. Because to walk after the Spirit is to have on the full armor of God on you always. The devil can't penetrate that. Thus, when the trials and tribulations come, because they will always come, then your faith will withstand them all. Because you know the God you serve. Because you know that you are standing on the solid rock of your salvation. Therefore, you will be immovable, unshakable. 2 Samuel 22:47. The Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock, and exalted be the God of the rock of my salvation. So make sure you stay walking in the Spirit. Stay armored up. Ephesians 6:11. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Be Spirit-filled and Spirit-led. Ephesians 5:18. And be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit. Romans 8:14. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. This is how you continuously resist the devil. James 4:7. Submit yourselves therefore to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Love you all. God bless you all.